Hello everyone, I'm Naman Gupta from Core Enterprises, and I'll take you through a journey of the cigarette waste, and I'll show you through a picture, a group of pictures, that how we are helping the nation in benefiting environmentally as well as generating employment. We started in 2016 with a basic idea that what is cigarette butt. Like, we considered it as cotton. So 90%, just like us, we had a bunch of friends who used to have a paying guest, because we were in our 20s, we were in our college life. So out of 10 odd friends, 50-60% of the friends used to smoke. So after smoking, they used to throw away all the cigarette butt that was like generated, and there was no complete disposal of the waste. So with the basic idea that what is happening of the waste, we started researching of what the polymer is made up of, what is the cigarette butt containing. So we came across that this is completely plastic in nature, and it doesn't degrade within 10 to 12 years, and it can contaminate more than 1 liter of water. Even a single butt can contaminate more than 1 liter of water. In India, there are no specific guidelines regarding cigarette waste, unlike other countries, because there is no specific disposal bins or anything regarding cigarette waste. So with the basic idea, we started the code initiative, and we started approaching rag pickers, scrap dealers, and various other unemployed local people in three cities, Noida, Delhi, and Gurgaon, as our base. So 90% of the people laughed at us, that what are you doing, and what will you do with this kind of waste? It is so bad, and you are promoting smoking. So we told them that we are not promoting smoking, because whatever the quantity that you will be giving and whatever the efforts that you will be putting in, we will provide you with a basic incentive for the quantity. So some of the people who like got aware of the cigarette waste, they started supplying us with the quantity. So because of them, we made a good base of the cigarette waste. Besides the scrap dealers and the rag pickers, we started giving value bins, V-bins, to individual smokers who are like smoking at their home, or cigarette vendors who are like selling cigarette on the roadsides, and various commercial office buildings who were having specific smoking rooms for the users to smoke there for their convenience. So today we have installed more than 10,000-15,000 V-bins across India, and these are some of the designs that we use for V-bins. Like, these are completely stainless steel receptacles, and these are not very fancy, but these solve the basic purpose of the efficient disposal of cigarette waste. So besides that, the bin that we gave was not solving the main purpose of the collection or the supply model, because the general public used to use the bin as a normal trash can. So they used to throw away all the wrappers, all the matchstick, bottle caps, everything. So we used to end up with all kind of waste. So like, we were completely confused that how can we collect the waste and when will we start recycling it. So we hired a lot of women, like we had unemployed women in our local areas. So we gave them an incentive-based rate so that they could supply us with the separated quantity. Like, we used to give the normal waste to them, and after separation, they used to supply us it into two bags. One was for the polymer, the cotton material that is inside, and the other bag used to have the paper and the tobacco. So today we have approximately covered 10 to 12 states in which we are operating in more than 200 districts. These associations are made on contract. Like, if a volunteer is willing to work with us, or there's an NGO, or if there's a person who wants to invest on himself rather than doing some other work, so they can collaborate with us and they can supply us the quantity on a large scale and generate monetary income also. Like, we provide a basic rate of 200-250 rupees per kg for the cigarette waste. So on contract, these people are providing a very good income for the people who are working under them. And these people are also benefiting the environment because the waste would end up as general litter otherwise. This is the flowchart that we have, the treatment process. The main USP of our business is the recycling process, because in all over the nation, apart from us, there is no other organization that is recycling such kind of waste. So the polymer and the leftover tobacco is like recycled using biodegradable chemical compositions. These chemicals are completely fit to use and available in the market, but we don't outsource the chemicals to maintain the USP. So after the recycling is done, the wastewater that is generated from the recycling of the cigarette polymer and the paper, the wastewater is also recycled so that we can ensure that we don't have any carbon footprints, and we are ensuring that we run a zero waste propaganda. These are some of the images, like this is the form that the polymer looks like, and the leftover tobacco is converted into manure. So this polymer is used in multiple byproducts like keychains, cushions, mattresses, bean bags. We have a lovely concept of making air purification filters. I'll show you the images also. And besides that, the polymer, the tobacco and the paper is converted into organic manure. This manure is usable for wet soils because it has a higher carbon content and can be used as a very good pesticide. So these are some of the byproducts like cushions and keychains and mattresses. So these are completely customizable. You can purchase the same byproducts from anywhere in the market. Like, we have online stores, offline stores for marketing these byproducts. And these are like durable, completely fit to use as per the ISO certifications. Because some people ask that if it is used by, it is made out of recycled cigarette butt, does it have any smell or something? So we can assure them that it is completely recycled and it is completely fit to use. Within this coming 2 years, like by 2020, we are planning to launch a bunch of byproducts like soft toys and mosquito repellents from the leftover tobacco and the paper. Because of the higher carbon content of the tobacco, the mosquito repellents can help in curbing mosquito problems in our cities and various areas. Soft toys will be completely similar to cushions and mattresses. Besides that, because the cigarette butt has a lot of absorbing compositions, like it can absorb a huge amount of chemicals. Before smoking, it is completely white, but after smoking, it turns yellow or brownish. So it absorbs a lot of highly effective chemicals. So we are planning to launch an air purifier which can be completely used for industrial chimneys and ventilation systems, wherein there will be no electricity involved, just the membrane that is being made out of the cellulose acetate that will be required for changing within the time period that is like proposed by the product. The main reason why we are here is the team that we have, because the team that we have is completely correlated. Our team is completely dependent on each other. If one person stops working with us, our complete system stands still. So this is the complete management team is completely involved with the unskilled team also, so that we can maintain transparency within the model and we can encourage more and more people to join with us. The benefits of our organization are like very high, because apart from us, there is no other organization who is recycling cigarette waste. So, and the waste is so harmful that it will take 10 to 12 years to decompose, and it can contaminate a lot of water bodies. So it is solving an environmental purpose of reducing soil pollution and water pollution. Besides that, it is our core enterprises is providing social benefit to the users who are unable to dispose their waste wisely. So we provide them with a value bin so that they can dispose their cigarette waste wisely, and we can recycle it into the various byproducts in the most efficient manner. Apart from the social and the environmental aspects, we have generated employment to more than 4,000, 5,000 unemployed people, job seekers, volunteers who are like willing to work towards the cause. And we have provided them with a basic income so that they can sustain and survive with their livelihood. Basically, lastly, I would like to say that whatever you want to do in your life, it's your life, you can do whatever you want, but you need to have a specific determination and you must focus on whatever you want, because if you are in your 20s or 30s, you must be investing over your studies, your courses. But if you try to focus on your own self and if you prove yourself that I can do something for the environment and I can bring about a change, so the people will also definitely help you towards the cause, and you will definitely flourish in the future time.